Welcome to Time Travel 75 and a look at Westbourne Fender Works man Tony Puttock's cine films taken at rod runs and shows in the mid-70s. Before that, a short film from Matt Fuller taken in 1973. We're going to kick off at the British Drag Racing and Hot Rod Association Street Rod Nationals held at Shepton Mallet as part of the Bath and West show on Saturday, 2nd of June 1973. Down from Scotland, Alex Scott's award-winning Morris Minor with Ford V4 power, and next door, John Anear's Austin A35 pickup. The show was made up of rods, customs, trikes, kit cars, beach buggies and VWs. On the Sunday, the show moved on to the Mendip Hills for a rod run. This pot belonged to a Southern Roadsters member and had their plaque on the bank. Another Southern Roadsters plaque on Terry Howell's VW trike. The British Drag Racing and Hot Rod Association Street Division was run by Cliff Scrumble Duff Watts from Somerset. Ace of Tubbs was Roger Pyle's four-seater tea bucket. This is Pete Watkins' mini tea. Four weeks later, and it's time for the Southern Roadsters' second annual rod run to Beaulieu. John Wilkinson was there with his MGB-powered Sunset Red Model Y. Another Red Model Y came from Essex, run by Jim Warriner, a member of the Chelmsford Dragon Hot Rod Club, and it ran a Twinks 1300 Ford Lum. And of course, Bob Rocky Wockwell was there with his Model Y. Bob's Y had a side valve 100E motor topped off with an Albert overhead valve conversion. Alex Scott was back out with Little Queenie. Not all rods had four pops in 73. Barry Tracy's Mr. T had a 427 rack. and Nick Butler used a free 71 old rocket power in his Nickelodeon bucket. Time for some driving games as Jerry Cross brings out his VW trike. Bruce Eggleton and friends take this 57 Chevy for a blast. John Wilkinson has a go in his Y. It's Ivan Fryer in his Ivan the Terrible Mustang, which he also ran at the dregs. Pete Ballam brings out his custom Capri. Finally, Roger Pyle in Ace of Tubs. On now to Tony Puttick's cinefilm, starting in January 1975 at Crystal Palace for the 5th International Custom Car Show. That's Jim Capone's Olds engine in his tea bucket, which got runner-up Best Model T. And this is Chris Boyle's just completed VW trike called Too Much, which won Best Motorcycle despite having three wheels. Al Llewellyn got Best Show Card for his custom Escort pickup. Later in the year, he fitted a dummy blower. The Rutherford brothers had a new paint job on their Jag-powered Pop Street Odyssey. Over from Sweden, the Canon Toyota Celica funny car. Best Model T went to Eddie Wimble's Immaculate Outlaw. The Corvair-powered Pink Panther trike was over from Sweden, and the Brown Moggy is Astral Traveller. And again from Sweden, a 1970s Sportster chopper called Super Swede. Nickelodeon was back out, still looking good. Alex Scott had replaced his Morris Minor with his Magic Boss Mustang, and he took Best Paint. Martin Hoyle's custom painted Marcus was called Armageddon. Tony Thacker had his Triumph chopper there, complete with plenty of tin foil and a shot of Gary Glitter on the bike. This is the ex-Church Brothers Tea Bucket, run by Tim Martin. The Silver Flakes 51 Ford Victoria, customised by Richard Park and Mike Rutherford, was sparkling under the lights. That's the Elliot Ness Special and Owen Williams Warp 8. Backfire with another Swedish funny car with Volvo body and bloke rat power. Here's another look at Street Odyssey. Pete Darwell's Mustang got runner-up best paint. And that's Pete Bailey's 58 Corvette. There was even a custom boat at the show. Ros Pryor got best dragster for her fast lady slingshot. That's Alan Sharp's V12 Jack Slingshot Meth Drinker. This Simca powered dragster came over from France. Another VW trike was Brian Godper's Honky. This is Keith Harvey's imported Sea Altered. On to March 1975, when the Southern Roasters held a show at the United Services Garage in Portsmouth. Representing the drags was Pat Cuss with his injected Hemi slingshot rat catcher. Ivan Fryer was back out with his Ivan the Terrible Mustang. In this shot is the Happy Hooker Sea Cab, Tony Puttock's Tea, the Lazy Lotus Pop, Phil Chappell's Multicoloured Pop, and Puddle Jumper. Over 40 rods and customs turned up, and at the end of the weekend, £50 was raised for charity. Chris Irwin in the hat and Alan Wigmore were promoting drag racing on the National Drag Racing Club stand. Chris Boyle was back out with his trike. This is Pete Harris's flame-painted Avenger. Lazy Lotus was run by Phil Baines and powered by a twin cam Lotus. The Happy Hooker C cab had a 283 Chevy and it was run by Graham Baker. On now to the Chelsea cruise, possibly the first one in May. That's Simon Lane's Fordston and Steve Ryan's Austin Grilled Minor and Crub Clifford's Pop. Mike Kaysen was there as usual with his Olds Cutlass, and that's Kim Patton's Consul Capri. To Beaulieu now for the Southern Roasters' fourth annual Rod Run, held on a sunny weekend in July. That's Graham Loke's Chopped Model Y, which was new out in 75. He called it Brown Sugar, and it had an Austin Cambridge motor, the original I-beam up front, and a Jag independent rear. Prize entry was this 34 Ford Coupe, owned by a visiting US serviceman and still on California plates. That's Dave Driver's midget-powered Topolino, and just behind, Bill Whitcomb's 57 Chevy Convert. Bob Rothwell was back out with his Model Y, now with Anton slots and 1300 cross-flow power. Bill Carter cruises in with his 390 Ford Galaxy-powered 34 Morris 10-4, called Hillbilly Express. And there's the Southern Roasters chairman Derek Chapman's old rocket-powered tea. And Tony Puttick's tea, powered by a Daimler Hemi. Thank you. Derek Chapman heads the cruise through the New Forest to Beaulieu. That looks like Tim Cook's tea in front of Bob Rothwell. There's Alex Scott's Mustang. And the Ford V8 powered Warlock Sea Cab in front of Paul Whelan's Chevy powered Cortina. The yellow T is John Jules, powered by a 1500 Ford. That's Martin Jackson's ribboned VW. And Paul Bird's red pop. And here comes the Y's of John Wilkinson and Graham Lokes. Once at Beaulieu, it was time for the driving games. That's Phil Chappell's pop and Tony Puttick's tea, representing the Southern Roasters at Wicksteed Park, Kettering, where the NASC held their first Street Rod Nationals over the August bank holiday. Keith Harvey's Model A pickup was looking good with blown Chevy Mouse motor up front. This 36 Oldsmobile was a clean looking stocker. Once again, the driving games were popular. Not sure whose tea this was, but it looked interesting. And that's Tony's tea again, being admired by a couple of future hot rodders. Best van went to Craig Bowles' Econoline, which he brought over from the States. And of course, no 70s rod run would be complete without the welly throwing competition. Wicksteed Park was a perfect setting for a rod run. Linda Scott got best paint for her American Graffiti Corvette. Paul Whaling's 283 Chevy powered Cortina took best custom, best engineered, and also participant's choice, beating Keith Harvey by 2 votes. Kev Pittman was there with his Midnight Rambler Pop, as was Bob Wilding, an Electric Funeral. And here's another shot of Phil Chappell's Pop. Tim Cook and Bob Rothwell present the awards. The end of 1975 saw another custom car show, billed this time as the first national custom car show, and it was held at Olympia and attracted 50,000 visitors over 6 days. Even Australia had an entry, a customised 100E. Ray Hoare had his Turbo Saxon rail there and took best competition car. And that's the Sunset Chevy T on the NDRC stand, alongside Stripteaser. Ros Pryor was back out with her Slingshot Fueler. And that's Rick Fielding's Daimler-powered Altered. And Nick Newton's Jag-powered Austin pickup-bodied Altered. The Egyptian E-Type Jag took Visitor's Choice Award. Kevin Pillin had his Steel 32 5-window there. Best Freewheeler went to Chris Boyle's White Trash Trike. Ed Wimble took Best Model T with the Outlaw, which was looking better each time it came out. That's Bob Hughes' 1500 Ford-powered T. And Pat Cuss's Ratcatcher, now fitted with a Topolino body. Best paint, best rod, best van, best interior, best engineered, and best NSRA car all went to John Bollicino's Hot and Bothered. Suffice to say, everybody loved it. To Beaulieu for the Southern Roasters 5th Annual Rod Run in July 1976. Terry Richards in his ex Jeff Beck T and John Spats Wilkinson with his Model B fill up with fuel. Tony Puttick was filming from his tea bucket, and following was Chris Brown in his 1100 Ford powered Old Iron Fordson. The Show and Shine at Beaulieu was packed with over 100 rods and customs. Steve Birch had his burnt orange metallic chopped 1933 Austin 10 there. Mike Key had his Model B there. He wasn't too keen on the flames and was planning a repaint. Ray Christopher had a turbocharged 1500 Ford in his C-cab pickup. Dave Driver was back out with his Topolino. And that's John Sargent's High Riding Zodiac. Chris Shearing was there with his fish-scaled Humber, complete with sump on the bonnet. Paul Money ran this Chevy-powered Escort. ...1976 saw Tony Puttick debut his 32 Roadster, all shook up. He used Jago components and a 4.5-litre Daimler Hemi taken from a hearse. He took it to the dregs, running in competition altered. On now to February 1978 at Alexander Palace for the third National Custom Car Show. This is Alan Butcher's chopped Jago 5 window, painted black with red global flake and plenty of lacquer. Engine was a 289 Ford, later replaced by a 302. Here's another Jago 5 window with 302 Ford power and the 6-wheeled custom Range Rover of Omar the Mysterious Arab. Hot and Bothered was back out, but taking visitors' choice was the new Bollicino built Austin Ruby Small Fry, powered by a blown Rover V8. The new mind blower from the Butler stable was Andromeda. The blown Hemi tea bucket took home plenty of trophies. Best amateur car went to Brian Lucas and his Chevy powered Jago Model B Roadster. Nick Butler had also brought along his blown Rat Sea Cab Revenge. Matt Matthew had his steel free window 32 there, which had been imported from the States in 71. And this T was also built in the States and owned by Bo Sandberg from Sweden. For the funny car fans, Nobby Hills had brought along Hound Dog. Mickey Naylor was running his Slingshot in Top Fuel for 78. The custom car Fiesta sat proudly on the custom car stand. That's Tal Pawney's Ford Pilot California Dreaming. We'll be right back. Bob Welstead's Moulin Rouge was now green. Best American streetcar went to the impressive Roaring Rat 57 Chevy of Tony Vanderpoot. There was no mistaking Bill Gibbs' shocking pink humdinger. Rob Whitwell was there with another Jago 5 Window 32. We're back at Beaulieu now for the 1978 Southern Roadsters run and another look at Tony's 32 Roadster. Pip Biddlecombe arrives and he's blown Daimler Hemi Austin Ruby Rebellion. Tony climbs into the fur interior of Rebellion with his camera for a cruise around Beaulieu. Ron Waters' T-Tub on the left. Looks like there was a vintage car show going on at the same time. I wonder what they thought of all the hot rods. Martin Kelly's Jack T and the prefect of Reg Noyce. That's Tom Reynolds' escort van and Ray Christopher's Centaur T.